I told you Robert Pattinson couldn't bulk up for Batman. It's an offhand comment. I spilled some tea during one of my live streams, and I was surprised how many other outlets picked up that little bit of gossip I gave members. It was a public live stream, though. Before the pandemic, I was doing one public live stream a week on Wednesdays, and that comment just took off. But the usual trolls came out, and they were like, "Don't be ridiculous, Grace. Of course Pattinson's going to transform himself physically like every comic book actor before him." And I have to say, on that note, that's something else that Zack Snyder doesn't get enough credit for. He has a workout guy who transforms all of his actors into the incredible physiques that they have in his films. Although, to be fair, over at Marvel, Chris Evans and Chris Hemsworth both did a fantastic job bulking up as well. But not Robert Pattinson. As I told you, you can clearly see he has not changed at all. You can not only see it, but he talks about it. So yes, yesterday, GQ, that, by the way, the GQ editorial team must be patting themselves on the back or doing it virtually because, you know, we're quarantining in place. But that magazine managed to trick the actor into doing his own photo shoot. I can't believe that anyone on Pattinson's team said that was okay. I'd be like, who here on Robert Pattinson's team is going to risk their life to go to his apartment and take, you know, and oversee this? But, you know, the gag was that Robert Pattinson had to do his own photos because, you know, coronavirus. And, he leaned into it, boy. He really leaned into the gag. I think somewhat to his credit, which we'll discuss. But I think the two biggest takeaways from the interview yesterday, besides realizing how important stylists are, also I have to say, when he's in the movie, they'll be doing his hair and makeup and stuff, and they have costume department. Robert Pattinson doesn't just show up and walk on camera. But the biggest takeaways were, A, he has terrible and dangerous cooking skills. He made pasta with sugar and cheese slices, processed cheese slices, in the microwave with aluminum foil. You can't do that. And B, he said that while his trainer has begged him to keep out his workout regimen during the forced break from filming, some of the other cast, they're very chatty in quarantine, has revealed they've only shot about, I think, like a third of the movie. They have a lot to go, so that makes me worry about even their new October 2020 release date. Clearly Robert Pattinson is barely able to hold a physical physique at all, because it's only been 2 months that he's been off of the set, or 2 or 3 months, and he wouldn't lose all that in just that amount of time. I mean, he might have lost some of the muscles, but he would still be heavier. I mean, he looks exactly like he did before they started, before he went into, secrecy to shoot Batman. He looks exactly the same. He hasn't transformed himself one iota. And Robert Pattinson's proud of it. He said that it's ridiculous for actors to have to get all jacked up. James Dean never had to do it. Although, if you look at older films and the physiques of those actors, it's clearly a very different time. As they always make jokes about it, a lot of tummy sucking in. Nobody actually really had six packs. Like Robert Mitchum was considered, to have an amazing physique at that period. And, you just don't see the definition that you do today. And also, I have to say, in terms of the James Dean defense, James Dean never played Batman. But if he did, I think it would look a lot like what Robert Pattinson is doing. Now, some people on the internet laughed, and some people said Robert Pattinson wasn't taking the legendary role seriously enough. What was my reaction? Well, I saw someone who trended for a little bit. I mean, he was just outside the top 10 for a good portion of the day, but towards the end, he got into the bottom of the top 10. That's impressive. And he might just be the millennial Batman that DC fans don't deserve, but that Warner Brothers needs to get the DCEU back in the front, the forefront. I mean, they're doing so far very well with Wonder Woman and Aquaman, but they need to get these other, very strong brands back up there. And people are interested in what Robert Pattinson is doing. He might really appeal to, he appeals, I think, somewhat to the Snapchat, now TikTok crowd, right? And that's, of course, what Jared Leto's Joker did. So this reminds me, actually, a lot of that situation. In fact, Leto and Pattinson are very similar types creatively, the way they conduct themselves. Very strikingly similar when you think about it. And I thought David Ayer and Jared Leto had a brilliant twist on Joker. And I've talked to you about this before. To take the mobster angle that was usually applied to the Batman Rogues Gallery and instead go with gangsters to finally make it more modern. And I thought that was really great, and people were captivated by it before the movie came out. Because unfortunately, Leto delivered a mixed bag for the actual film. And Ayer recently tweeted out that Leto's best work was, in fact, left on the cutting room floor. How weird! What should we lose? What should we cut out of the movie? How about all of Leto's good stuff? That really sucks. Now, as for Matt Reeves, I would like to, first of all, assure you that he knew who he was casting when he cast Robert Pattinson. So he knew what he was getting into, so that must factor into his plans. And again, the cast, which is getting awfully chatty during quarantine, have been talking about how this is going to be a darker, more emotional film. And to be honest, even in these photos, Robert Pattinson totally looks like the type of guy who would decide to dress up like a bat and hunt down other crazy people to somehow avenge his parents who are still already dead. I mean, it makes a lot of sense to me. I told you I love the Batman Earth 1 twist that Jeff Johns, in fact, dreamed up, where Martha Wayne, her family name is Arkham. She's from the Arkham family. She married into the Wayne family. And so that gives Bruce a little bit of crazy. No, it takes crazy to fight crazy. I like it. But also, I'd say this doesn't reflect very well on Alfred's parenting skills. And Andy Serkis has talked about how this movie's going to really focus on Bruce and Alfred's relationship as a father-son. And I'd be like, oh, that's very touching. But you got to admit, Alfred, you kind of messed up a little bit. Child Services likes, maybe we should have visited there more often. Anyway, I'm not too concerned about this for, again, two reasons. A, I've seen Robert Pattinson in the Batsuit. We all have. And I think he looks pretty darn good. Clearly, it cheats a bit. It adds a little bit of bulk, in the suit itself. Like, just like with the Shazam suit, I bet it stands up on its own. This seems to have more articulation, so it probably wouldn't actually. But, you know, it worked out fine with Shazam. Look, Zachary Levi, I know some of you will point this out, he did bulk up, but he didn't bulk up to the level of the suit. But he did bulk up underneath. More than Robert Pattinson did, to his credit. And then B, as some fans are pointing out, Reeves and Pattinson's Batman is a detective. So as long as they don't try to sell us on the idea that he can throw a punch, he's not going to be able to throw a punch. But he's surely clever enough to figure out how to evade one and crazy enough to take the few that he can't. I'm sure this Batman looks to me like he likes getting punched. He's like, do it again. And also, you know, he can come up with clever ways to outsmart the criminals, to come up with other, you know, that's why he has so many cool weapons, because he can't throw a punch. I mean, I don't think it's imperative that Batman, well, I don't know. Does he have to be in peak physical form? I mean, it's with Batman, it's always mind over matter. And so as long as it seems like Robert Pattinson's mind is sharp, I laugh because that might be a little bit difficult. But if he can sell us on that, I think you can sell us on the rest of it. I just hope this is something that everyone can get behind. And that Matt Reeves, Robert Pattinson, and Warner Brothers stick the landing, unlike what happened with David Ayer and Jared Leto's Joker. That just didn't work out. Even though, again, everyone was very interested in it before they actually saw the movie. And again, I appreciate Elseworlds stories. I can see the beauty in the change, in the different depiction of Batman. I like that stuff. I like it a lot. But so far, mainstream audiences have proven to not be fans of Elseworlds stories, so that makes me a little bit nervous. I would hate to be hurtling towards another David Ayer Suicide Squad situation. You know the film will be better made, story-wise, because I think Matt Reeves is a stronger filmmaker. So I still feel very good about it. I just think we all need to understand that we're getting a different type of Batman. So what do you think of Robert Pattinson's comments and his physique as Batman? Share your thoughts down below, subscribe today, and of course, as always, you can check out some more videos right now.